So, talking about that, the first application of thermal energy is to produce low temperature. I mean, low temperature are produced by what we call the flat plate collectors. I don't know if you have already seen it on the roof of some houses here. There are plenty of applications of this. We have building heating in Europe, in America. We have also hot sanitation water production from some hospitals in the rural area. It is very important for them. For swimming pool also heating. For solar cooling. Instead of using electricity produced from, let's say, thermal central like fuel, electricity production central, we can use straight solar for cooling and also for drying. Like you can see here, a dryer, a medical dryer or any kind of drying, we can use also this low temperature application. So we call this type of, let's say, system flat plate collectors. We have several types of flat plate collectors, okay? I don't want to go over this kind, because this one are the most used actually in the world. We have also, and this one is the very important one, the high concentration, the high temperature application. We call them concentration plants. Okay, these concentration plants, the temperature they can reach is in the range of 200 to 1,000 degrees Celsius. I don't know if you guess what is it. So this can enable us to produce a very important electricity in a town, for example. We can produce from a few kilowatts electricity to several megawatts electricity. So the system we have here, for example, the solar field, okay, that we through this solar field we have thermal fluid who will collect energy from these solar collectors, and with heat exchangers in this area we'll exchange with what we call the working fluid inside a thermodynamic cycle, okay, that we will use, for example, a turbine to produce electricity. Okay, this kind of application is not well known, because I recognize that it's very complex, very high technology. But the very important thing you have to know is not in every country we can have this kind of application because of solar radiation. We have what we call the beam radiation or the direct radiation, which is very important to run this kind of plant. So if you take, for example, Europe or America, if you take Europe, it will be at the south of Europe, like Spain or a bit in Portugal. And if you take America, it will be California. In this area, you can have the beam that the beam radiation that could enable to run this kind of application. We'll come later with this type of which area to use this kind of application, and you see that Africa is the only place we can really use this kind of application to produce electricity. So I want now just to show you a different let's say types of this concentration plant. We have like four different types of this concentration plant. First of all, we have what we call the public toll collectors. So do you see they are cylindric and also parabolic, and they have what we call linear focal, let's say, in which the thermal fluid go through. Okay, we have mirror, these are mirror, and here we have like a line, a tube inside which a fluid will go through to receive energy, because energy, the solar radiation will come from the sun. Excuse me, my laser is not working well. So it will come from the sun, will arrive at the mirror, and it will be reflected to the focal, to the linear focal. It's not here linear point, it's different. You see the one of linear point. And this kind of application, this kind of concentration plant can reach the temperature at the range of 200 to 400 degrees Celsius and can produce several hundred kilowatts. This one, if I'm talking about kilowatts, here is the thermal kilowatt, not electricity. Okay. And we have also what we call the concentration, the compact linear Fresnel reflector. It's like the one just I showed you, but the difference here was to do the parabolic shape of this collector is very tough, it's very difficult. And the big part of the investment costs is, let's say, taken by the way they have to